strength and conditioning stuff in here, and then obviously all the skill stuff I put the other place, so whether it is grappling, boxing, MMA, and just try and fit it in. I have plenty of rest days, so I'm getting a bit old.
Mic check, 1, 2. Go get him. Listen close, nigga. Yeah. If rappers want it, they can get it. Flow tighter than four fat bitches sitting in the Civic. My flows are unimaginable. Hannibal Lecter, shit. Eating MCs for breakfast, bitch. Since I was born and touched the mic the first time, it's been a problem. Your life was a mistake. Your pop should have wore a condom. You niggas think you hard. I think you better come harder. I leave rappers confused like Will.i.am Barber. Fucking with looters, not a great look. A verse will make your fans unfriend you on Facebook. Click, my styles are going in the label.
Got a few rounds today with these lads this morning, and then boxing tonight.
Yeah?
Yeah. So yeah, double session. In a whole nother house for my cars, it's on my checklist. Cause the fit 'em in one garage is like a nigga playing Tetris. But they say patience is a virtue, cause I got your bitch staying out way past the curfew. Guess I was a thief that got away with these words. Slanging chickens out my whip like I've been playing Angry Birds.
Coaching and training with Sam on the regular, in my opinion, he is more than ready. He has been more than ready for a while now. It's just been very difficult to match him. His training is insane. He's multiple training every day. I mean, I suppose that's the benefits of owning a gym, is you can train whenever you want. He is just an all-round athlete. Being an ex-rugby player, it gives him the upper hand. Another thing which also gives him the upper hand is he's already faced his opponent once in a jiu-jitsu tournament, Mariam Sandu. He is a legit grappler, high level blue belt. Sam faced him in the absolute of a tournament and beat him. So going into this bout, Mariam's got to at least be thinking, okay, he's already had the upper hand on me once, got to try not to let it happen again. We've studied Mariam's tape. He's 1-0 in the cage. We know what we need to do in there. Sam's more than capable of easily pulling off a win. Complete confidence in Sam.
You're not eating sweets today?
Not today, not this early.
Mate.
Not this early.
Yeah,
21. Biggest.
What's up?
Time to cool this.
Yeah, the chicken man.
Bro.
Pussy.
Hurry the fuck up. Hurry the fuck up. What made you start MMA in the first place?
Heartbreak. No, I'm joking. I don't fucking know. It's like fighting. My mum didn't like me doing it when I was on the pitch. So, do it in a controlled environment. Bosh.
Nice.
I have no idea anything about my opponent other than his name and who he's fighting out of. I don't really know anything more about him, but don't matter because the result's going to be the same anyway.
Good afternoon, Oates.
Good afternoon, one, good.
How you feeling, Bill?
Yeah,
well, look, Dan's peacocking. You're fucked.
I'm not.
Mum, I'm not.
My hand's getting raised after the fight anyway. That's a fact.
Submission, strikes.
We're going, I want to stand up this time. My last round, my last fight, it was all ground and pound. Just didn't really get hit, so I'd like to have a bit more of a brawl really this one. If it goes to ground, I'm just going to try to get back up again. If the submission's on, we'll go for submission, but it'd be good if we can get a stand-up fight, aim for a knockout, get that finish.
So you're fairly comfortable on your feet, but you've also won gold at a grappling contest, haven't you?
Oh yeah, Devon Open, gold medalist, 3 out of 3 fights. That's my first competition. Yeah, it'd be good feeling that.
What were the finishes? All points, or?
I won 1 on points and 2 by submission. I had a guillotine and a Americano.
Americano?
Yeah.
That's a coffee, isn't it?
I don't know. Americana.
Good session, boys.
The rage champs, baby.
Good. What you got there, Bill?
Grapple soap, baby.
I need your name and who you're representing.
Alright, Dan Lucas, Fight Night Lift MMA.
Is this your first bout, Dan?
It's my first MMA bout, yeah.
Yeah? How do you feel?
Ready for it.
Turn it up a bit more and have fun. Check me out though. Look. It's cops to dodge in the city of God to reach the goals of these soccer stars. It's records to break, medals to take, flags to wave, the city of ours. It's hills to climb, the road winds, only lights is gold from a beamer.
What do you know about your opponent?
Not too much, just say he's a striker, he's a blue belt, same as me. We'll find out, won't we? Chill out here, it's foretold by
Kalorja, the old most rock cells don't end well. Nice. When your own country treats you like an infidel, it's eyes that need as well. Don't box into a corner eye, flow like a butterfly. Nice.
6 days a week at the minute, running pretty much every day. Jiu-jitsu, striking pretty much every day as well.
We've got Dan primarily training with Billy today. Billy also fighting on Raged UK on March the 4th. Just thought it would do them both good to train together. They're both young, hungry fighters with a goal to achieve. They've both got their own unique skill sets, which match up well against each other. So Dan's transition from striking to ground is phenomenal. It's so quick, he's explosive. I thought of Dan, he was primarily going to be a jiu-jitsu player, but looking at his striking, you would have honestly thought he's been doing it for years. I know previously he's had two kickboxing bouts or K1 bouts. He's a great young talent.
40 seconds. What happens if you lose? Are you one and done?
No, it's the next one.
Good man.
The next one.
It's not going to happen though, is it, Dan?
No, not a chance.
Not going to fucking happen,
chance.
Is it, Dan?
Not
you
chance.
Don't seem very up for it. Come on, Dan!